Altieri of Wine Channel TV, and welcome to Sip Some Austria, where wine is just the beginning of the story. Today I'm at Vino Faktur, joined by Wolfgang. Wonderful to see you.
Prost. Good to see you.
Thank you for having me here today. Wait, this is pretty cool. We're standing on an old-time original wine press.
Yes, it's built in 1744.
Oh my gosh.
It's pretty old, yes.
That's really neat. There's a lot of great history. First, tell me about the area we're in and about the store. It's huge.
So what we do here is having a platform for local producers, local winemakers, just to sell their products, handmade mostly in family-run companies. Mm-hmm. So they get over here and sell the best what they have.
And what I loved is when you walk in, if you go to the right, then there's the, I call it the exhibition area. So first you see the pumpkin seed oil tasting station. So that's very, very big here. In Styria specifically too.
Yeah, pumpkin seed is called the green, the Styrian gold.
Oh, I like
the
that.
Green gold.
The green gold.
Yeah, and so we do some like an amount of 7 million liters pumpkin seed oil every year.
7 million liters.
Yes.
I love it. Every day I've been here so far, I've had a little bit. It's so good. And then we kept walking through the exhibition. I'll give everyone a visual. Then we came up to, I saw the big pig and the chickens on the wall. So talking about the local meat, that is very important here as well.
The small producers produce the very best meat all over the world. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's slowly grown and finally the best pig and the best chicken in the world.
Oh, nice. And then we took a little bit walk around the corner, and I know then you had the local chocolates from the area too. Some spirits, was it schnapps I saw too?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. And then I remember we walked and right at the end, it was the picture of all the wine queens from the area. What is that?
So we do elect a wine queen every year, different one, and two wine princesses as well.
Okay.
They were elected by different winemakers from the area.
Oh, that's so fun.
They do represent the Styrian wine all over the world.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a great way of tying in the history and the culture with the wine. And then once you finish the exhibition, you walk into here, which I call sort of the big warehouse of all of the wine. Tell me, how many producers have their wine in here? I see all their pictures on the wall.
Yeah, we have more than 50 producers.
More than 50,
selling their wines over here.
Oh, that's great. And talk to me lastly about the wine we're drinking today. It's one of the founder's wines.
It's one of the founder's wines. It's a Holz Sauvignon Blanc, 2015. It's a very fresh, fruity and good in the acid.
Yes.
So we can drink it all day long.
Very bright and refreshing, hints of the lemon, a little bit of lime and grapefruit notes on there.
That's it.
On the nose. This would be perfect with some grilled fish, or what else are typical dishes from this area that you would pair? I know you're in the restaurant business
light
first.
Light meat dishes as well.
Okay, light meat dishes.
You can have it as well to some salad with some roasted meat on it and so.
Oh, I like that. Okay, we'll have to go enjoy some food and the wine on your patio.
Later on.
That'd be perfect.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
Taste the products as well, yes.
I like that. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Until next time, I'm Jess, reminding you that wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. Prost.
Prost.